This video demonstrates the technique of combined trabeculectomy and trabeculotomy with a releasable suture and cannuloplasty in the management of congenital glaucoma. This child presented with bilateral congenital glaucoma with corneal edema more in the left eye than the right eye. Sclera is barely visible due to bophthalmos. Globe is rotated downward with a corneal stay suture. In Indian population, congenital glaucoma present with more severe corneal edema that makes trabeculotomy with or without trabeculectomy a preferred primary procedure over goniotomy. Trabeculotomy is to remove obstruction caused by a congenital angle deformity and trabeculectomy is to bypass episcleral venous pressure. Releasable sutures provide titratability of aqueous flow postoperatively and excellent control of intraocular pressure. Limbus-based conjunctival flap is made and minimal electrocautery is done. Partial thickness rectangular flap is made of 4mm by 4mm using Castrovisio caliper. Careful dissection of sclera is done till the clear cornea is reached. The limbal anatomy is carefully studied under high magnification. Incision is made at a sclerolimbal junction. The incision is gradually deepened to cut the external wall of Schlemm's canal. Opening of external wall of Schlemm's canal or cannuloplasty functioned like a modified de-roofing procedure. This is the most important and skill-intensive step of the surgery. As soon as the external wall of canal is cut, aqueous starts oozing out. Since the most of us are right-handed surgeons, the Hamm's trabeculotomy is passed through a left side first. It is rotated into anterior chamber to disrupt trabecular meshwork and open the internal wall of Schlemm's canal into anterior chamber. Same technique is used on the other side to perform around 100 degree of trabeculotomy. Straight blade Vanes scissor is used to perform cannulotomy of Schlemm's canal. With the help of 11 number blade, an entry into anterior chamber is made. jelly sponge is used to create an opening of around 1500 microns in the trabecular area. Peripheral iridectomy, slightly bigger than the size of sclerotomy opening, is made. A 10-0 nylon suture used to close pleural flap. Two sutures used at the corner and two at the margin of the flap. One of the corner suture is a releasable suture which will pass through the cornea and which can be pulled out postoperatively to titrate intraocular pressure. Conjunctiva is sutured continuously with 8-0 Vicryl. This is a pre-operative photograph compared to third day post-operatively shows complete disappearance of corneal edema and also shows reversal of cupping. Thank you very much.